Hello, this is Cynthia Sue Larson with realityshifters.com, and I'm here today to talk with you about quantum jumping. I'm interested in the subject because for a long time I've noticed that when reality shifts happen, it often seems like we've moved between a couple of alternate realities. And I notice this because sometimes I'll be literally noticing that something has changed, it's appeared, disappeared, transformed, or transported. And the reason I notice it is because something was different. It's almost as if I'd walked from one world to another. Now, the idea of quantum jumping and doing it intentionally is extremely relevant and even regularly practiced by professional athletes, because these are individuals that really need to succeed and do the best they can to have an optimal level of performance. So when it's a process of just visualizing that something is possible, holding a really clear conceptualization of that, and imagining that you can create a bridge from the reality that you're in to this other one. So this could be done through visualization techniques, affirmations, and what have you. But it's also necessary to establish kind of a bridge between worlds. And this can literally be done by imagining something like a bridge, or a window, or a door, whatever it is that works for you. And also attaining a state of relaxation and energization. Because what we're doing, and the reason that this name quantum jumping is so popular, people tend to think that's a really big jump, but actually the term comes from the quantum physics world, where a quantum particle, such as an electron, literally disappears from one level, state level of energy, and reappears at another level. And in the laboratory, scientists have been observing that this actually does happen. A quantum particle literally blips out of existence, turns into pure energy, and reappears at a different level. This happens when an electron is energized, and we can do something similar in our lives because we are also made of quantum energy at our very core. So there's just a lot to think about, but the practical application of it is extremely relevant and pretty straightforward. Once again, you can do something like this by imagining, for example, that you'd like to lose weight. And if you're doing that kind of an example, then you'll be imagining that you are in a state where you don't need to eat that much because you're not that hungry. You feel satisfied eating foods that are good for your body and not in excessive quantities. Maybe you even feel like you're the kind of person that exercises. All these things tend to come together in this other reality. And the more you believe that you can just walk into that reality, and this is a state of achieving enough focused concentration and also meditation, and then bringing this energy so that you can walk through from one world of possibility to another. And some people might call it faking it till you make it. That's another way to look at it. And this is often a term that's employed when people are climbing the corporate ladder. So they might dress the part of someone who's got more salary, more prestige, more recognition, and so forth. So all of these different examples give you a sense of what it's like to move from a level that you're currently at to another level. And when you think in terms of the fact that there could be another reality just that close at hand, and all you need to do is visualize how good can it get, which is my favorite question, and establish the possibility that you can create a bridge from where you are now to that other reality and bring some energy to it, because you need that when you're going to a higher level, then this quantum jumping is something that you can do. So until next time, this is Cynthia Sue Larson with realityshifters.com, inviting you to keep asking, how good can it get? Thank you.